Hi, welcome to Appalachian State's Digital Learning Resources. In these next few videos, we're going to be talking about the Tascam DR-70D. In this video, we're going to be talking about understanding the playback and recording screens, how to navigate the menu, how to initialize the Tascam back to factory default, do a quick format of the SD card, change the battery type, change the date and time, and lastly, how to change the file name. All right, this is the Tascam DR-70D. One of the things I really like about this device is how it has the quarter 20 screw on the top as well as a quarter 20 port on the bottom. This allows you to mount this a camera on top of this and then mount it to a tripod, which really works well with most workflows. So it's a really great feature about this device. If we move to the left side, you'll see we have the power on off switch as well as the hold. The hold is what allows you to lock the device so you don't accidentally change any settings during recording. Beside that, we have three XLR / quarter inch ports. That means you can plug in either an XLR cable or a quarter inch cable into these slots. If we move to the front, you'll see we have two internal microphones. We have a left channel and a right channel microphone. We also have a door which covers the battery compartment. We can hold four AA batteries in there. And there's a slot for the SD card. You just push that in, the SD card comes out and pull it out. Moving to the other side, we see we have one more XLR / quarter inch port. We have a micro USB port for bus power or data transfer. We have an external in. We'll talk more about this in later videos, but this allows you to connect an 1/8 inch microphone into this port. We have a remote port. The remote is sold separately. We also have this in and out and a little camera icon. This allows you to connect to your camera. If your camera has a headphone out, you can plug that into the in and record your camera's audio directly to this device, or you can go the other way and plug the out into your camera's microphone port, allowing you to synchronize the audio from this device into your camera's recording very seamlessly. And then lastly, we have a headphone jack and volume rocker for your monitoring headphones. On the back of the device, we have an LCD screen. We'll talk more about this in a moment. We have different menu buttons. This button is a wheel / button. It allows you to navigate the menu very easily. We have these toggles for changing your gain. We have these gray buttons, which do different things depending on which menu system you're in. We have lights for dual recording, if you have dual recording turned on, or if you're recording, that light will come on as well. We have the record button, and then lastly, we have the slate button. To power it on, I'll slide the hold power switch toward the power icon until the startup screen appears on the display. Looking at the LCD screen, there are a lot of icons, so let's go over these in detail. The top left icon is the recorder operation status. Next, we have the elapsed time in hours, minutes, and seconds. The smaller time code shows the remaining record time available on the SD card based on current record settings. At the bottom, we have the current file name. And if I use the search buttons, I can search through the different files that are available on this device already recorded. So that's buttons 3 and 4 to search through. When I press the play button, the operation status shows a playhead. The elapsed time starts counting up, and if I press and hold one of the search buttons, I can scan through and fast forward the file. Pressing stop pauses the current file, and then pressing stop again takes us back to the home screen. During recording, the operation status icon changes to a circle to indicate that we're recording. The elapsed time will count up, and the remaining record time will actually count down. You can press the record button again to stop the recording or press the stop button. The monitoring mode icon indicates what you're listening to in the monitor. Mix means the current recording channels, and cam means whatever is plugged into the cam in plug on the side. If you have auto tone turned on, you'll see a little slate icon. Beside that, you have the power supply status. If the current channel number is highlighted, that means the channel is turned on and will be recording. A non-highlighted number means the channel is off. The low cut, limiter, and hold icons follow the same logic. Highlighted is on, not highlighted is off. If you see an XLR icon beside the number, that means that channel has phantom power turned on. We'll talk more about phantom power in a later video. These dots below the elapsed time and these bouncing bars are your level meters. The black caret there indicates a negative 16 dB. And lastly, this shows you the peak value in decibels. Now that we've looked at the entire outside of the device, let's look at the menu. Press menu, and using this wheel, we'll scroll all the way down to others, and you'll press this wheel to select it. Go to system, press to select. We'll go down to initialize and select that. It'll give you this dialog. We'll hit enter. If this is your first time using the Tascam DR-70, I definitely recommend initializing back to factory default and starting fresh. Next, we'll go to quick format and format the SD card. Remember, if you have any content on your SD card that you need to copy off, do that first before formatting. I don't, so I'll go ahead and hit enter. After we format, we'll hit menu and go back to others. We'll scroll down to battery. And because I have a nickel metal hydride battery in here, I'll change that from alkaline to that. We'll go back, go to file name, and you have a couple options. You can either choose Word, which will do whatever word you type in here, but I prefer to use date, and it will do it whatever the current date is. For now, I'll just leave it at Word. Go back. And go down one more for date and time, select that. You'll need to press this 3 and 4, which will move it across, and then you'll use this wheel to turn up and down to enter in your time. Once you're done with everything, press this and enter in your date. All right, that's all we have for this video. In the next video, we're gonna be talking about how to set up your Tascam to make your first recording.